Hello and welcome to Terminal Velocity, explained by me, QHat. If you ever go skydiving, you'll notice that while you start off speeding up, eventually you'll stop getting faster and maintain the same speed for the rest of your descent. This constant speed is called your terminal velocity. It's not just skydivers either. Pennies thrown off buildings and hail dropped from the sky also eventually reach a different terminal velocity. But if you've ever seen still images of a ball dropping from a few feet, you'll notice it doesn't do that. It just keeps getting faster and faster and faster. Why then does an object falling sometimes stop getting faster? The answer is drag. See, when you're falling from the sky, you're hitting a lot of air molecules, or should I say, a lot of air molecules are hitting you. And the faster you go, the harder the air collides into you. That's this equation right here. So how does this relate to terminal velocity? Well, when you're falling, two things are happening. Gravity, which is roughly constant, pulls you down, and all those air molecules push you up. Subtract one from the other, and we see that generally, gravity wins out, and so you speed up as you approach the ground. But as you start to speed up, you'll eventually be going fast enough that the air is pushing you up just as hard as the Earth is pulling you down. Now gravity doesn't win out, in fact, neither force does, and so you're free to fall to the ground at terminal velocity, without speeding up or slowing down. By the way, if you were to repeat the dropping ball experiment, but from really high up, you'd be able to reach terminal velocity. A ball dropped from a low height just doesn't get fast enough. Also, here's the actual equation for the drag force. The variables explain why different objects have different terminal velocities.